Olivier Panis's 2002 season started in Melbourne with limited running during qualifying, as he faced setup problems with the car and a retirement on the first corner of the race at the aftermath of a big accident between Ralf Schumacher and Rubens Barrichello. The Frenchman had another tough qualifying for the second Grand Prix in Malaysia, where he faced various mechanical problems during the one-hour session and ended up 18th on the grid. His race wasn't better either, with BAR's clutch failing on lap 9. Having completed just 8% of the laps in the opening races, Panis was hoping for a change in fortunes in Brazil. But the BAR 004 continued to be slow on low fuel runs and very unreliable. This time, a broken gearbox took him out of an uneventful race on lap 25. On the reliability front, things continued to be bad, and at the San Marino Grand Prix, Olivier parked his car in the pits on lap 44 with throttle control issues. With four races completed, neither of BAR's drivers had scored any points, and given that the next F1 stop at the demanding Catalunya circuit was going to expose the car's disadvantages, another miserable weekend was looming ahead. But somehow, with 22 laps remaining, Panis had climbed into the top 6, having started 13th, and was set for his first points of the season, before a cracked exhaust forced yet another retirement. For the Austrian round, Panis qualified into the top 10, but as soon as the green light showed, he started to drop down the order. Then, the cursed Frenchman provided one of the season highlights when his engine seized without warning on the start-finish straight, locking his rear wheels and spinning wildly at the center of the track. The Monaco Grand Prix was the scene of his only F1 win back in 1996, and in 2002, that seemed eons away. Panis qualified a lowly 18th, and during the race he collided with Button at Saint-Devote. Later on, Panis admitted that he had not seen the Renault on the inside of him, taking the blame for the crash. This would be his 7th straight retirement in as many races. The next trio of races provided Olivier with a much-needed morale boost. He finished 8th with no issues at the Canadian Grand Prix, 9th at the Nürburgring, and scored his first points with a 5th place finish at the British Grand Prix, albeit behind his teammate Jacques Villeneuve. Now, hopes were high for his home race in Manicourt, but Takuma Sato managed to destroy them right at the start, colliding with Panis and sending him straight to the gravel. Later on, Olivier retired from the damage and made sure that Sato's boss knew exactly how he felt about that incident. The Honda power was evident at the fast Hockenheimring, and Panis qualified a season-high 7th for the race. Sadly for him, equally evident was his engine's unreliability, blowing up on lap 39 as he was running a promising 6th place. A rather anonymous Hungarian Grand Prix, where he finished 12th as he started, was followed by more engine-related problems at Spa, this time both during qualifying and the race as well. Monza was said to be a good opportunity for points. Things got off to the wrong foot as Panis qualified in 16th position, but he made up for it during the race. He climbed up 4 positions over the opening lap to finish 6th on the lead lap and into the scoring positions for his 3rd and final point of the season. Following a 12th place finish at the United States Grand Prix, Panis finished his season at Suzuka in typical fashion. Having to stop on track and use the spare car during qualifying, he would retire on lap 8 with electrical troubles. The French driver retired in 11 out of the 17 Grand Prix of the season and covered just 64% of the available laps. He gathered 3 points, one less than his teammate Villeneuve, and finished a disappointing 14th at the driver's standings.